The biggest benefit of working with Webex is your ability to share content. Now you can share websites, videos, Swift animation files, PDFs, Word documents, Excel documents, whatever it may be. In order to share something, you have to be the presenter of the meeting. Now that doesn't mean that you own the meeting or you set up the meeting. For instance, right now the presenter of the meeting is Jessica Eddington, who's the actual host of the meeting and set this meeting up. But let's say I want to become the presenter so that I can share my screen or I can share a particular resource with the rest of the participants in the meeting. How do I do that? Well, in order to become the presenter, you need to grab this presenter ball right here and drag it onto your name to become the presenter. This essentially is literally like moving the ball into your court. So it'll say, do you really want to become the presenter? And you choose yes. Now, when you become the presenter, you're now in control of what people see. So now I can close whiteboards if I need to, and I can choose whether to save it or not, and I can create new whiteboards if I need to. So I can start typing some content. I can create my own annotations and call out shapes, and I can erase things, I can point things out, whatever it may be. Now I can also go up to the share menu, and there are a lot of different things I can share. I can currently share my screen, which is going to show my entire desktop. So be careful and make sure whatever's on your desktop is what we actually should be willing to see, or you're willing to let us see. Now for my screen, this would be really helpful if maybe I was switching back and forth between a couple of applications, and that might be something you want to use. I can also share a file. So let's say I wanted to share a particular PDF file. So now this file is going to load, and it can be PDF, Word document, Excel documents, whatever you need it to be. And if I want to see different pages, I can open up this navigation pane here and scroll through those pages. I can also add annotations and point things out, and I can highlight certain areas with shapes, and I can even draw and paint my own notes. Same thing if I did a video or if I did an image, I can share all of those things as well by going to share and choose file. I can also share an application. So I can come in here and share any open application that's already ready on my computer screen. So I'll click Firefox, and it's going to open up that application and share it with the rest of the meeting. So right now, they can see this particular area, but all of this area out here, even though you can see it in the tutorial video, they wouldn't be able to see this. It would look grayed out, because that's what sharing just an application does instead of sharing your entire screen. Now, when you're sharing something and it's showing up with this whole screen like this, you can come up here to this little menu bar, and this is where you can stop sharing, you can pause, you can assign people to take over your keyboard or mouse. So if you're running into trouble and you want somebody to actually control your computer and get you out of trouble, you can do that as well. You can come in here and change your audio settings, mute yourself, look at the participants, chat, all this different stuff. It's all up here, but it's just more in a collapsed form so we can focus on this particular application that you're sharing. So let's go ahead and stop sharing that and go back to share. Now you can also share or create a new whiteboard. You can share web content, so you can add a URL here, and it's going to open it up as a tab instead of actually opening the entire application. It's going to open it up as a tab here. Now the last thing I want to show you is that you can share your meeting window. So this is good for when you're having trouble, let's say your audio's not working or something's not going right with the WebEx. You can actually share this entire meeting window, and this will allow people to help you troubleshoot because they can see your screen and walk you through different steps. When you're done sharing whatever it might be that you're sharing, you can pass the ball to somebody else to become the presenter, or they can actually drag it themselves. Let's go ahead and pass the ball back to Jessica Eddington. So it'll say, do you want to change the presenter to Jessica? Yes, we'll change it. And notice now that you can't change to different whiteboards, and you can't change or do any of that stuff. You can still come over here and go to the Quick Start and Meeting Info, but now the presenter controls what the active tab is showing.